Hi guys, it's ANTS Britannia, and today I'm going to be showing you my brand new trapjaw ant colony. These girls originate from Southeast Asia and can be found in tropical rainforests nested under deadwood or stones. I have attempted to recreate their environment by using sand mixed with cocoa brick. I have also added a small piece of deadwood, which I purchased from my local aquatic store. These girls also love their humidity. They love it so much that I have to keep the ground moist at all times. But now let's talk about the exciting stuff, the ants themselves. This type of trapjaw ant is called Odontomachus Monticola, and they can span a size of a whopping 13 millimeters. The trapjaw mandibles open to a full 180 degrees, and when it wants to, it can close its jaws 2,300 times quicker than the blink of a human eye. So I decided to greet them with a little bit of honey water. And as you can see here, this worker is loving it. And after some time had passed, a second worker arrived to enjoy the honey water as well. And before you know it, with the use of chemical communication, more and more workers poured in to have a good old drink of the honey water. Now, you can feed these girls honey water, as you can see here, sugar water. You feed them any kinds of fruit. I sometimes feed my ants tangerine juice, like orange juice. I try to freshly make it. It's always best fresh. I included a small clip in my ant hibernation video on how to make this. If you want to, you can check that out. But I think, guys, it's time to feed them some protein, and that means feeding them a cricket. So I decided to start with a dead cricket. I know he's jumping around, but that's just his muscles spasming. The ants quickly take interest in the cricket. But this is swiftly disregarded and ignored. So after some time had passed, I decided to take the dead cricket out, pull its leg off, and put the leg in to see if they would take any interest in the smaller piece of meat. After more time had passed, I just thought, what the hell, and I decided to put a live cricket in. And as you can see here, the trapjaw ant goes straight for the live cricket. You can also see her snapping down with her large jaws and stinging repeatedly with that deadly stinger. Now, the sting will paralyze the cricket. The ant will wait for it to be paralyzed and will proceed to take it back to the nest to be eaten alive. Thank you. So guys, after a week had passed, the trapjaw ants had dug themselves a nice little hole in the substrate. I had to change their formicarium around a little bit, because the wood, the dead wood that I had put inside the nesting area, had got a little bit rotten and started having fungus and mold grow on it. And I decided to add some rainforest substrate, which contains a lot of bark, soil, and little bits of dead wood. This is especially great because the ants originate from a rainforest environment. After spreading all the rainforest substrate around their nest, without getting bit, I decided to add a small piece of fake foliage, a small fake fern, and I decided to apply some water to soak into the bark and recreate that naturalistic effect of their small environment here. So guys, the ants are doing really well now. They've settled in really well since I got them. I feed them honey water every day. I give them a cricket or two every single day and they take it. They've got a very large appetite considering they are very large ants. I've seen a few of the workers running around with eggs and larvae, so I can't wait to see the kind of next generation of ants, and I can't wait to do another video, an update video, on how these guys are getting on. Of course, I didn't catch these guys in the wild here in the UK. I had to buy them online, and I bought them from an ant store called britishants.com. So if you want to check them out, I'll leave a link in the description below. But now guys, it's time to announce a winner from last week's competition. If you didn't watch last week's video, it was a tutorial on how to build a plaster formicarium for under £20. That's under about $25 for you guys in the US. So be sure to give that a check out. I'll leave that link in the description below. And our winner is Henry Maravilla. He gave a great description of Lasius alanius. So Henry, if you're watching this, be sure to contact me on my email. You'll find my email in the description below. So there it is guys. I hope you enjoyed this brief video showing my brand new trapjaw ants. As you can see in the background here, I've got a small recording of a tiny Lasius nige colony I recorded in the wild. This was recorded on my Instagram page. So if you've got some time, be sure to head over there and give us a follow to keep up with any kind of like behind the scenes or any updates that I may have. And if you've got a little bit extra time, be sure to check out the old Facebook as well. But other than that, guys, thank you for watching. If you're new here, be sure to click the blue ant to see more of my videos and hit the subscribe button to join the colony. Have a great weekend, guys, and I will see you next week.